You know, these numbers very clearly show that as of now, the projection of the projected supply till the 31st is 126 crores. And the total number of people we need to inoculate before the 31st, double vaccinate 60% of our population, is 126 crores. So then where is the surplus?
Well, you have a very valid point, and everyone looks at from that actual numbers, but it's a balancing act. We have a group of fence sitters, we have a group of hardliners who will never get vaccinated. So if that is true, and if that in fact makes 2% or 3%, we will have 2 to 3% of surplus. And also if we are able to, you know, vaccinate 1.23 CRs every day, it will be worthwhile. So I know it's a very important balancing act, but I have a feeling that in next 2 to 3 months, we will have 4 or 5 new vaccines. We will have Zydus, we will have Sputnik Light, we would probably have no vaccine from Serum Institute. So if we add the newcomers and the micro mRNA vaccine from India, I think we may have a surplus, but certainly we must fulfill our commitments to the countrymen, our people first. And yes, if we have an international obligation like to COVAX or to WHO for our neighboring countries, that should be taken after we have inoculated our people first.
Yes. Dr. Laharia, I want to come to you. Do you feel that if we take the vaccination drive, I won't say lightly, but if it is not done by the 31st of December, what we had initially set out to do, we run a risk of inviting a third wave?
What we need to remember that the situation in India is very different from situation in other countries. In India, the Delta variant came first, and then we are doing vaccination where even a single shot is more valuable than two vaccine shot in other setup. That's one. Second thing is what we need to remember that we might not need the number of doses which you are projecting around 126 crore, because what we need to remember that anybody who is coming for vaccination starting first week of October, if they are getting Covishield vaccine, they would be returning for their second shot only early 2022. So in October onward, only one shot will be given for majority of the people. Of course, the people who are coming for Covaxin will get another month later, but anybody who is getting vaccinated in December, starting 1st December, would be returning for their second shot in January 2022. So the requirement would be very different. What would be the requirement? The October to December, mostly people will get one shot, and people who received their first shot in last 3 months would be returning for second shot. So our need would be very limited, not the entire requirement. No. It is not going to make a lot of difference if people, all entire population is not vaccinated by end of the year, because what we need to remember, we have already achieved around 2/3 of the population with single shot, and more number of people will be coming for second, first shot and second shot. So we are in fairly good condition. The final part is that we are now recognizing, realizing that no country can be safe unless people all across the world are vaccinated. So while we have thought logically for about the country, but it's so very logical, and especially India need to show to the entire world that we think about all other countries. So what India is going to do, resuming vaccine mandatory, is the right thing. It will not affect India's vaccine requirement. What I personally following this thing, and I personally see starting mid-October, India would have far more supply than the demand from the population.
Yeah, so that, if that happens, if this projected supply changes or increases dramatically, then it makes sense.